Alright. Hindi sila pala makabalak pa kasi ready yung mga cellphones nila. Okay. So, batiin muna natin yung ating mga friends from our blogging industry and media.
Hi guys, good morning sa inyo lahat. Good afternoon na pala. Maraming salamat sa oras nyo at sana mag-enjoy tayo ngayon. Thank you guys, it's for Alo Tinere. Yeah.
That's a big support sa buli.
Hi everyone, good afternoon. Thank you for coming here today and thank you for joining us and for supporting Alo Together. I hope you guys enjoy this MediaCon and I hope you guys enjoy the movie when it's out. Thank you.
We'll truly enjoy it. So now, let's start. Kung meron po kayong questions.
Kailangan. Easy tayo.
Dire-diretso na natin ha. Una, Alone Together is the title of your film. Sobrang daming nai-intrigue. Kasi, una sa lahat, yung slash pa lang, medyo ano na. Tapos, very contrasting yung Alone Together. So, if any one of you can give a glimpse kung bakit kaya ganito yung napiling title. Kasi na nag-story ko tayo, wala pa pong title.
Ako parang ang take ko sa kanya, magkasama kaming nag-iisa. We're alone, but we're together sharing that loneliness.
Go! Ako, sundan mo yun. Dapat, ano?
Dapat coordinate yun.
Pass.
Parang, pass. Well, it's very sad, yeah. You know, I think a lot of people in this world really feel alone, even though they're with their loved ones. Ibig sabihin, maybe they're not happy with their life. They feel so alone, even though that you know that their great love is there. So, minsan kasi, you know, yung great love, it doesn't necessarily mean it's the right love. Diba, Derek? So parang ganun, feeling ko. Great love, hindi naman lahat ng great love ay natutuloy. So, may ganong feel. Yung panga.
What he said.
Okay. Like, pressure, I don't really feel pressured as much. I mean, syempre nervous, sana magusto ng tao. Ayun naman talaga gusto namin. Usually, the movie really grosses is because people really enjoy it and like the movie. And so yun lang talagang iniisip namin, sana they enjoy the movie, they understand the movie, and they really take something home after watching the movie. I think that's really what matters. Kahit kumita siya o hindi, we did a really beautiful film, and in the end of the day, I think that's what we're supposed to do.
Hi, Gazelle.
I do feel the pressure right now.
I'm thrilled right now.
Very honest.
I do feel the pressure. Like, each and every time naman na gumagawa po ako ng isang pelikula, nagpa-pressure ako kasi alam ko naman that people have to pay to watch the movie. And of course, gusto ko, masusulit nila yung bayad nila pag nanonood sila. And whenever, pag lahat naman kami, pag ginagawa namin ng isang pelikula, we always do our best. Pero syempre, lahat ng tao may iba't ibang opinion. And hindi naman may iiwasang isipin kung, isipin yung mga opinion nila. So, yun. I do feel the pressure. Difference ng movie na to sa My Ex and Wife. Well, My Ex and Wife kasi was a rom-com. This one is a bit heavier, I would say, and a bit more mature when it comes to the different emotions and yung pinagdadaanan ng characters namin. And ang masasabi ko lang, handa na akong masaktan this Valentine's Day.
Oh! May ganun. Okay.
Well, magugulat ang mga fans sa movie na to. For sure, 100%.
What he said.
Yeah, thank you so much, guys, and good luck and congratulations.
Thank you, Bob.
Kasi it was yung pinalabas, ano pa lang siya, teaser siya. So the main goal was to tease.
Yes.
So parang to patikim lang nung kung ano yung mangyayari sa movie. Tapos this week we're going to release a full trailer na mas maiintindihan na kung ano yung pinagdadaanan ni Christine sa kanila.
As far as the characters are concerned?
I think, in a way, nakaka-relate ako kay Christine kasi she's very idealistic. Pero marami din siyang parang fears. And I think normal, I think that's what makes her human. Kasi lahat naman tayo, we have big dreams, big plans for ourselves. Pero at the same time, we know what's practical, we know kung ano lang kaya ang i-achieve. So I think on that, doon ako nakaka-relate sa kanya.
Sa akin naman, actually it's a very, very weird take on mine. Wala nakarelate ako sa character ko because of my best friend. Sa totoong buhay, he's like my brother. I grew up with him, he lives right beside my house. Yung pangalan ko dito si Raph, yung pangalan naman niya, Rafael. We call him, people call him sa school Raph, pero I call him Bubot. Exactly kung anong pinagdadaanan ng character ni Raph, yun din yung pinagdaanan niya sa buhay. Sa relationship niya with his girlfriend tapos. So as in, kung anong yung pathway ni Raph, mga problema niya, mga pinagdadaanan niya with him, exactly, yun ang nangyari sa best friend ko. So, nung binabasa yung script, sabi, bro, parang ikaw to, bro. Tapos pangalan ko pa Raph. So I think that's, doon ako nakarelate. Hindi sa like, I haven't really experienced anything like Raph. Pero because he was my best friend, so nagkakwento ko. Basta lahat ng problema, alam mo yung mga barkada, tol, ito ang problema ko ngayon, tapos ganyan. So figure for like, almost a year and a half. Yeah. He's been going through it. Tapos yung girl niya sa ibang bansa na. So, doon talaga ako nakarelate. It's very weird kasi sabi ko, bro, sobrang sakto. As in, I couldn't even believe it. So, yeah, medyo weird siya.
Derek, is this pretty much true to life stories that you've written? Or is this like a character just
pure
based on your...
Pure fiction
na? Yeah.
Or may inspiration
with? Wala naman. It's a parang general feeling of going back to your youth. Kasi at one point or another in your adult life, you feel like you lost your idealism, your dreams that you had when you were young. So parang it's a parang character study on how adults feel about their life now. Are they happy? Are they? If you're successful, is that what makes you happy? What makes you really happy as an adult?
And direct some locations po tayo nakarating, which is of course obviously yung UP po.
Yeah.
What are the other locations that you shot?
We shot in UP and in the National Museum. So parang in sa Pilipinas yun yung major milieu niya. National Museum and University of the Philippines in Diliman, and also basta Manila area. And then sa second half ng story, some significant scenes were shot in New York. So ayun, so Manila and then New York.
Did you graduate in UP also?
Yes, in UP Diliman.
So guy, based din ba some of the scenes because of your experiences?
Yeah. Definitely. Pero parang kasi ako, graduate ako, 2006. So, I had to do more research kasi yung year nung character ni Christine was 2010-2012. Eh, medyo nag-iba na yung UP from the time that I was there nung ngayon, nung 2012, tsaka sa ngayon. So, kailangan i-update para mas maging makatotohan.
And did you do like a more millennial treatment, you think?
Hindi ko sasabihin parang more millennial treatment, pero mas ang treatment ay memories. Parang memories, going back to your happy times in college.
Okay, thank you so much.
Alright, thank you. And just before we move on,